The drone part is a particular way of making a sound that usually lasts continuously for some time and generally lies quite low down in pitch. Why he's called it the drone mass, I'm still slightly puzzled by. Obviously, he's thinking of all the mass settings over many centuries by so many different composers, which generally is an extended piece in five or six sections.
Well, drone mass is a setting of the Coptic Mass. Sometimes it sounds like early music, sometimes it's incredibly emotional and effective and affected. It sort of is both a very extroverted and introverted piece.
The best way to understand what the drone mass is to listen to it. And the minute you hear it, you are pulled into the universe of the piece.
All that drone mass looks quite easy on the page. The tonal material is accessible, definitely. It still requires a lot of precision. Because it's so transparent, it must be utterly in tune to sound okay. I mean, you can hear if we're not doing it well. So we're rather exposed. Technically, most voice parts are stretched, you know, as far as we can go. Low and high, but also sits extremely nicely in the middle. So it's very rewarding that you actually get to use your whole instrument as a singer.
In a way, the drones are sort of defining each movement and defining the character of each movement. As we play, sometimes the intervals are very open and sometimes they're very close, and so they're just sort of the base from which we feel different feelings and hear different frequencies.
Once you begin to look for the details in the score that relate to the word drone, then they are there almost the whole time. But sometimes they're there in disguise.
I do think he also meant like the drone to be also interpreted as sort of like the drones, like small unmanned airplanes flying around and keeping watch over us.
The character of Jóhann's music I find very difficult to put into words. He's clearly been influenced by minimal music in the broadest and different senses of that word. And out of that, he's created his own voice. So when I come to his pieces, whether it's the drone mass or these little pieces written specifically for a film track, I see the same person at work. I see the character of the man in his music.
It's a piece that, you know, that is a wonderful experience in terms of slowing everything down and letting everyone, you know, contemplate, but it's also not a piece that simply lets the audience feel comfortable.
I think if you hear drone mass the first time, you will experience it like a journey in some ways. It never stands still, even though there are recognizable elements. It doesn't stand still. It's like a voyage that floats on an electronically generated, you know, sea of files that overlap, rumbling, different kinds of electronic soundscapes. And voices go in and out in that, and it has actually sort of one big shape where you take off, you know, nice and easy on a good day, and then there's quite a lot of turbulence, and then it calms down and you end again in a very calm environment.